So congratulations on the show. I mean, the first series was such a huge success. I mean, were you prepared for just how big and how embraced the show was going to be?
No, I don't think any of us were. And it could have gone either way, because I think the BBC is so blessed and honoured by us all that in many ways this could, possibly should have been a homegrown production. And yet Netflix has the capability, the finances, obviously, and the talent to stage something this broad, this wide. Peter Morgan, writer second to none, and luckily garnered a fabulous group of people over a long period of time. But we could have been kicked to death by the critics. We didn't know. We had no idea. So we feel very blessed. And I think the second season, in many ways, is more exciting because we know the people now. And of course, it has to always be a person-driven story. We had the wonderful spectacle in the first of the coronation and the wedding and all of that, and now we're bringing it down to what would you do in this situation? How would you react? So it's beautifully put together, and I'm very good in it.
Also, when you get to, I mean, somewhere like this, when it's so embraced, you get to a second season, so many people want to know what's going on, but then you get the opposite where you don't want to give anything away and you're thinking with spoilers and everything else. I mean, did you have to, was it a question of you being, I didn't want to know too much, or?
I think we had to sign something to say we're not allowed to say anything about anything, but look, 1955 to 1965, so if you know a little bit of history, you'll know there's a Suez crisis and there's Kennedy coming over and, you know, there's a lot of good bits of politics going on. But very interestingly, we flash back quite a lot to Philip as a young boy, and we see the father figure of Mountbatten with him, and then the present day Mountbatten is also fathering Philip's son, because Philip can't really do that with Charles when he's up at Gordonston. So we see this going through the generations, this man who's a very powerful figure in both people's lives. So it was wonderful to do, very, very, very touching to come absolutely down to the personal rather than here's the first Sea Lord and the third in line to the throne, because it has to always be about people.
The great thing with this show is, well, obviously announced season 3, which is going to have this big time jump, it's going to be a different cast and everything else. Yeah. I mean, for you as an actor, are you excited to see where they go and what these new actors, whoever they bring in, including Olivia Colman, where they go and everything like that?
It's interesting to see who they cast as me 20 years older, because I'll be 20 years older in 20 years, and will I still be working? I don't know. But whoever plays me will have fun, because by season 4, he gets exploded by the IRA. But we had to do it because each season is 10 years, so we'd all be round about the appropriate age for episode 1, season 1. By episode 10, season 2, we're 20 years too young. So you have to move it on. And I think they'll get some wonderful people coming in, because it's been cemented well, hopefully, by us youngsters.
If you could pick someone out of the air, who would it be? It's Netflix after all.
Harrison Ford would be very good, wouldn't it?
Go big or go home, right?
I have to think of that. I don't know. Who would you pick as me 20 years older?
How old are you now, I guess?
That's a tricky one, isn't it?
I'm
50.
There's lots of seasoned people. I mean, Sir Michael Caine could maybe do it, maybe? That's just off the top of my head.
I think Michael Caine's a little
maybe
bit old.
Maybe season 4.
I think the part's a bit too small for Mr. Caine. Really. It would have to be called Mountbatten for him to do it.
It'll be someone, I'm sure.
Yeah,
that'll
be good.
Yeah, I hope you have a great evening. Thank you so much for your time.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're watching Hey You Guys!
Hey You Guys, huh?
Hey You Guys,
is that from The Goonies?
It is indeed, yes.
Nice.
Hey